videos are just going to be a compilation of me being awkward in public with other people.
I mean,
that's what I just realized.
What are we normally?
Yeah. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first ever. What should I call this? I was thinking about restaurant test. Keep it in the same branding.
Restaurant?
Yeah, restaurant.
That's what it sounded like.
If you can't already guess, this is how this is going to break down. We are going to start the video by going to the restaurant, getting a certain dish that you guys suggest to me. It could be, try to keep it in New York for the first couple at least. We're going to go there. We're going to get the food. We're going to honestly review it. That's going to be the kicker too. We're not telling these people we're coming. We're not telling these restaurants we're coming. We're not trying to get any special treatment. We want to be like any normal customer to see how good this stuff actually is. And then I'm going to try to go home and teach you guys how to recreate them, because a lot of stuff down here is overpriced. Would you agree?
I would definitely agree.
Hopefully, if all goes well, you guys will be able to recreate this stuff at home. Today, we are headed down to Chelsea, not the market or pier, it's just called Chelsea.
Yeah, Chelsea.
To a restaurant called Cafeteria to try their mac and cheese spring rolls. I saw these things on Facebook a while ago. They went kind of a little bit viral. So we're headed down on the train now, and we'll see you guys when we get there. What a shot. That was crispy.
Crispy?
I'm in love.
They're very good.
The crisp on those things was unbelievable. That's gonna be the hardest part to recreate it. Getting a really crispy outside and not trying to dry out the middle. We'll see. That's gonna be tough.
I will have to agree.
So guys, we're back in the comfort of my own set, and we're gonna try to make these things. Now, as you can probably guess, step number one is to boil our pasta. So in some salted water, I threw in 8 ounces, or half of the box, of my elbows, strained them out, and in the meantime, started shredding up my 3 different types of cheeses. Now, I'm gonna use equal parts for this. 1 cup of the Monterey Jack, white cheddar, and the Fontina. For a couple of different reasons. Number one, I think it'll get us pretty close to the flavor of those egg rolls from the restaurant. And number two, I wanted to use all white cheeses so it looks the same, at least, if it doesn't taste the same. And now we can start on the actual cheese sauce. So 2 tablespoons of butter melted down, along with 2 tablespoons of flour, mix them together and let them cook off for about 2 minutes. I then threw in 1 cup of my whole milk and whisked that into my roux, let it come to a little bit of a simmer, and added in all 3 of my cheeses, along with a little bit of salt and some white pepper. Now this thickened up almost instantly. You do have to make sure your cheese is fully melted down. Just keep whisking over low heat. Don't melt it too quickly or else it gets a little bit gritty. You guys know the drill. And once I was satisfied with the way this was looking, I added in all of the pasta that I had cooked. Except for the noodles that went flying off onto the stovetop, RIP to them. Now just to make this a little bit easier to work with, I put it down in a circular pie tray and then into the freezer for a few minutes. This is probably optional, but I think it'll give us a better chance of this actually working out. And now it is time for the spring roll wrappers, which I'm a little bit intimidated to be using. I've never used these before. I was shocked to even find them in the store. Apparently you want to put them into some cool water for about 20 seconds to let them absorb some of the water and soften up. And then it's as simple as putting down some of your filling and kind of wrapping it up like you would a burrito. The wrapper seemed to have stuck together pretty well, so I repeated the same process for a second one, and now it's time to cook them. I'm gonna start with 350 degree oil here just as a test. I tossed in both of them and... oh boy. Ah, shit.
We have a problem.
That is definitely not what I was planning. It was recommended on the package to kind of form your spring rolls on a clean dish towel, so I'm gonna try that. Maybe it'll take some of that excess moisture out. I don't really know why the last ones exploded like that. I'm also only gonna try to cook one at a time this time at the same oil temperature, and luckily this one turned out a little bit better. I think this will be usable. And I don't know if the stars just aligned to allow me to get that one perfect spring roll. I was not able to get another one for a solid 5 attempts. I tried different methods of wrapping them up. I tried different oil temperatures. I went up to 375 and 400. I went down a little bit. Like, I don't know what's happening. And in my last ditch effort to get one more perfect one, I made up a couple and threw them in the freezer for about a half hour because most mac and cheese that you fry, that's probably what you do first. And praise the Lord, because they actually ended up working well enough to be able to plate anyways. And now I present to you the most ironic plating of 2018. A nice spinach salad to go underneath our deep fried mac and cheese fattening egg rolls. So it took me quite a few attempts. But we got something. Appearance-wise, it's gotta go to cafeteria. Theirs were perfectly shaped, they were nicely browned, plated much nicer, so on that front, they win. Taste is the real question here, though, so... okay. I can work with that. These did end up with a pretty nice crunch, and the flavor of the mac and cheese is really good. I would eat just a huge bowl of that. The creaminess and just the overall texture of theirs was perfect. Like, I can't even explain it, guys. These ones got a little bit dried out. Although I'm very proud of these, and I would recommend you trying them at home, if you can, cafeteria has to win. Theirs are just perfect. But I hope you guys enjoyed the first ever restaurant test. Let me know if you enjoyed this, if you want to see more, if you know any restaurants in the New York area that you think I should go hit up, because I'm making a list. I'm gonna try to do this all summer. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. I'm gonna be posting a ton more on Instagram now that I'm actually leaving the house more than once a week for these videos. But other than that, I hope you have an awesome beginning of your week, and I'll see you right back here for the next one. Until then, peace!